everyone, my name is Simona Cotin and I'm a web developer here at Microsoft. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add authentication to a web application. Azure Static Web Apps manages authentication, which is the process of verifying a user's identity, out of the box. By default, you have access to a series of pre-configured authentication providers or the option to register a custom provider. And the pre-configured ones include Twitter, GitHub, and Azure Active Directory. And to implement a full authentication workflow in our static web app, we can use a set of system endpoints that will enable us to add functionality like login, logout, as well as retrieve authentication-related user information. All right, so let's go ahead and implement and use some of these endpoints in our application. And as you can see here, I have my application running in my local environment. And if you haven't already, I highly recommend you check out the previous videos where you can learn how to set up this application as well as how to set up the Azure Static Web Apps CLI in your local environment. And throughout this video, I'm actually going to go step by step through one of the Microsoft Learn modules that we have available, which is authenticate users with Azure Static Web Apps. So here you can see that you have the instructions to run your application in your local. And one of the first things that we're going to do is really get the user login status. And we do that by making a query to one of the system endpoints that I mentioned earlier, which is /.auth/me in our client application. And in our case, that's a React application. So let's go ahead and edit the navbar component. And I'm gonna copy and paste the code here. So going into VS Code, opening the navbar component. At the top of the function, I'm going to paste in this code. And we also need to make sure that we import useState and useEffect, which will help us to store our user information into the state. So you can see here that we are fetching information from the system endpoint that allows us to retrieve that information, and then we store it in our component state. Okay, and we also want to add the login and logout buttons. But before we do that, I mentioned that we have a couple providers that are configured by default. Those are Twitter, GitHub, and Azure Active Directory. So let's go ahead and copy this providers array and paste it at the top of our function. And with Azure Static Web Apps, we also have the option of specifying a redirect URL once the login and logout actions are being completed. So we want that redirect to be back to the page, the current page where we are at. So I'm gonna define a variable here called redirect, which is gonna retrieve the window, the current path. And then let's go and add our login and logout buttons. So you can see here that if user information is undefined or doesn't exist, we are iterating over the list of providers, and we're adding a link to that makes a call to .auth login /provider. And this is where we're iterating over this array, which is Twitter, GitHub, and Azure Active Directory. And we're also specifying the login redirect URI, which will bring us back to our current path. And we said that we also want to add a logout button. So in case our user information already exists, so our users are logged in, then we want to display the logout button and the logout text. Awesome. So this means that we can test this information. We can test this functionality. If I go into our React application, I can see that now we have on the left-hand side a list of authentication providers, Twitter, GitHub, and Active Directory. So everything is now in place, and the final step is to test if everything is working as expected. In our web application, let's select one of the identity providers to log in. And in this case, I'll use GitHub, and we'll be redirected to this page, which is actually a fake authentication page, which is provided by our Azure Static Web Apps CLI. So let me just use this username learn and press login. And we can see now that the screen has changed so that I can see the logout button, and it also shows welcome, learn, my username, and GitHub, the provider that I've used. Let's go ahead and push these changes to GitHub so we can test them in our cloud application as well. So I've pushed this to the cloud and I've pushed this to GitHub. And what this will do is it will trigger a new action run in our GitHub repository, which will take our code and deploy it to our Azure Static Web Apps. And this will take a while, so I'm gonna fast forward here. Awesome, so now that our application has been built and deployed to the cloud, we can go into our web application and refresh. And now we can see that we have authentication providers, Twitter, GitHub, and Azure Active Directory. So let me go ahead and test this with GitHub. You can see that this is now the real screen that allows us to grant consent to this application. I'm gonna click grant consent, and now I see the same functionality for logging out and welcome Simona Co. You've authenticated with GitHub. All right, so in just a couple of steps, we were able to set up authentication using Azure Static Web Apps and add authentication providers like GitHub, Twitter, and Azure Active Directory. Stay tuned for the next video so we can see how we can restrict access to certain routes or roles in our application.